Hey guys, my name is Mohit Grover. I'm working here at Cisco as a tech engineer in call manager team. Today we are going to discuss how to collect traces from the call manager using the RTMT tool. So to start this practical, I need access to the CM administration page of the call manager. Here we can see I have logged into 1052 call manager, and to download the RTMT package, we need to click on the application, select plugins, okay, so I'll just scroll it down a little bit. Over here we can see the Cisco Unified Real-Time Monitoring Tool for Linux and for Windows. So I'm running Windows 7, I'll download RTMT for Windows. So as soon as you click on download, it will initiate download and it will show you a pop-up to save the file. I have already saved the file in RTMT folder. Let me show it to you. So this is the package and the package size is 80.7 meg. And the application is already installed on my machine, so I'll just, you know, initiate the application using this executable file. I'll just right click on it, run this application as an administrator. As soon as I click on run as administrator, it will show me login prompt. Over here we can see that we have to enter the IP address of the publisher. I'll just go ahead with the IP address 10.106.116.97. This is the HTTPS port and the secure connection checkbox is checked. I'll go ahead click on OK button. It is going to take some time. So as we can see here, it is now asking me to enter the username and password. So guys, over here we can see HTTPS colon IP address of the publisher colon HTTPS port, which is 8443. I'll enter the application username and password here, which is app_105. So the RTMT tool is now being initialized. It's gonna take some time and it is showing me time zone data version mismatch error message. So what I'll do is I'll just select no, which would let me launch RTMT with current time zone version. It's gonna take some time. So meanwhile, what we can do is we can set the trace level on the call manager to detail, and we can also verify whether the traces are enabled or not. So I'll just navigate to the CM administration, from CM administration to the Cisco Unified Serviceability page. Okay, I'll select the trace option configuration. This is the server which is selected by default because we have only one node. I'll select the service group as CM services. And right after this, I'll select services Cisco Call Manager. Over here, we can check the status of the service. It is showing active. Okay. I'll scroll it down a little bit and we can see here the traces are not enabled. So I'll just enable the trace. I'll just set the trace level to detail. I'll select the components. Suppose that if I'm facing issues with SCCP endpoints, then I have to make sure that the SCCP key product trace is enabled. So I'll enable it. I'll enable the speed dial trace as well. I'll enable all phone device trace. So it depends on the issue. Suppose that if you're facing call routing issue which is related to PRI, make sure you enable PRI trace. So in this case, I'll enable all checkboxes. I'll save the configuration. Over here, we can see the informational message. It is showing update completed. I'll now log in into the RTMT. As you can see here, it is showing me the configuration list. And this is the default profile. I'll click on OK. And now Our trace level is set to detailed. We can simulate the issue. And as soon as the issue simulation is done, we can go ahead and click the traces from the RTMT using trace and log central option. So I'll just double click on it. Over here, we can see collect files. I double click on it. It will pop up a dialog box. Okay, I'll select call manager option. And then there are two options available. Either you can select all servers, which will automatically check the relevant checkboxes for this particular component if you have more than one node. But in our case, we have only one node, then I'll just simply go ahead and click the call manager traces from this node only. I'll click on next. There are multiple components available. These are the system services and applications. Suppose that if you're facing issues with DRF, the disaster recovery feature, then you may collect, traces from here. So I'll not select any option here. I'll just click on next. So there are two options available here, absolute range, relative range. So I'll go with relative range here. I'll select 5 minutes. And there are multiple options available. Like, you can also go with hours, days, weeks, months. I'll go with minutes. And I'll select the partition as active partition, which is already selected by default. I'll go with download file directory, and then just select the location here where the downloaded files will be stored. So here is the location. I'll just copy and paste it here. You can see here that RDMT folder, download RDMT traces folder. And over here we can see it is showing zip files, do not zip files, uncompressed log files. So if you select zip files, what it will do is it will create a tar file and then, it will transfer the file. If you select do not zip files, which is a recommended option, it will not compress the file. And then the third option which is available is uncompressed log files. So if you select this option, all the log files, suppose that if more than, one file is there, so in that case, it will automatically uncompress all the files which are there in the trace folder. So I'll select this option, which is really good. So if you select this option, it will automatically, uncompress every single log trace file, and then you don't have to use third-party tools to, uncompress them manually. And if you select this option, it will delete the collected log files from the server. So I'll not select it. So far we have selected 5 minutes of the relative range, partition as active, download directory, do not zip file option, which is already selected by default. And we have also checked the uncompressed log files option. So as we could see the notification, it is saying that this option will increase the download time. That's fine. I'll click on finish. As soon as you click on finish, it's going to take some time. It depends on the trace or log files. So if the size of the log files or the count of the log files is more, then it's going to take more time. But in our case, it should not take more than, 10-15 seconds. As we can see here, the download has been completed. And it is showing completed downloading for node ccm105.cisco.com, and the cancel button is not highlighted, so we are sure that the trace collection has been done. I'm just going to minimize this application. I'll show you the download RDMT traces directory, and over here we can see the trace collection has been done. And if I click on trace CCM component SDL, SDL stands for signal distribution layer. So just to let you know, guys, over here we can see one. So this is a node ID. 100 stands for application ID, which is for call manager. If it is showing 200 over here, it represents a CTI manager. 300 is for CMI, Cisco Messaging Interface. In our case, it is 100. And this is the file name, or I should say file tag. So you can ignore this this side, and you can only focus on node ID and application ID plus SDL. SDL is sent for signal distribution layer. I'll just go ahead and open this file in Notepad++. And I'll just drag this window over here. Give me 1 minute. Okay, there it is. So you can see here the trace collection has been done, and the relevant information is there in the trace file. So guys, this video ends here. If you have any further questions, you may contact me at mogrover@cisco.com. Thank you very much for watching this video. Have a nice day.